The Lord be with you. I am Captain Samuel Kamau, leading this Palm Sunday service here at the A.C.K. St. Michael and All Ages Church, Ongatarungai. You are all welcome to celebrate Christ with us as we start the whole week. We are heirs of the Father, renewed in the Spirit. Our reading comes from the book of the prophet Zechariah, chapter 9, from verse 9. Let us read together. Rejoice greatly, O daughter of Zion. Shout, O daughter of Jerusalem. Behold, thy king cometh unto thee. He is just and having salvation, lowly and riding upon an ass, and upon a colt, the foal of an ass. And I will cut off their chariot from Ephraim, and the horse from Jerusalem, and the battle bow shall be cut off. And he shall speak peace unto the heathen, and his dominion shall be from sea even to sea, and from the river even to the ends of the earth. As for thee also, by the blood of thy covenant, I have sent forth thy prisoners out of the pit, wherein is no water. Turn you the stronghold, ye prisoners of hope. Even today do I declare that I will render double unto thee. This is the word of God. Let us put our hands together as we welcome our vicar to share the word of God with us.
Praise the Lord. I am Ogwenji James, vicar, A.C.K. St. Michael and All Angels Parish, Laisa Hill, Ongatarungai. You are once again welcome to our Palm Sunday service this morning. We are starting the Holy Week tomorrow. I want to encourage all of you to observe this week in prayer, reading and meditation on the Word of God, and fellowshipping with your family members. I want also to encourage all of you to hold brief services at home with your family on Monday, Thursday. At the same time, I request the heads of each family, that is the fathers, and where the father is not there, the mother or the eldest member of the family, to perform the humble rites of washing the feet of all the members of that family, to exemplify the humility of Christ that sent him to the cross to suffer for our sins. We shall stream the Good Friday service live on 10th of April 2020 at 10 a.m. and we invite you to come and worship together with us. Please continue to hold your daily services with your families from 8 p.m. to 9 p.m. as you pray for the needs of our families, the needs of our country, and also the whole world at large. Our message today is entitled, How Can We Sing? And the scripture reading for this particular message will be mainly and largely from Psalm chapter 137. Let us pray. God Almighty, we thank you because of this day, as we remember that on a day like this, you rode into Jerusalem on a donkey, as a lowly and humble and victorious king. And as people laid palm branches before you, they shouted, "Hosanna, Hosanna, blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord." So today, as we celebrate this day, we remember and we also shout Hosanna in our hearts. As we listen to your word speaking to us this morning, we pray for your presence and we pray for your help in Jesus' name, our Savior. Amen. Let us read Psalm 137 together. By the rivers of Babylon, there we sat down, yea, we wept. When we remembered Zion, we hung our harps upon the willows in the midst thereof. For there they that carried us away captive required of us a song, and they that wasted us required of us a myth, saying, "Sing us one of the songs of Zion." How shall we sing the Lord's song in a strange land? If I forget thee, O Jerusalem, let my right hand forget her cunning. If I do not remember you, let my tongue cleave to the roof of my mouth. If I prefer not Jerusalem above my chief joy, remember, O Lord, the children of Edom in the day of Jerusalem, who said, raise it, even to the foundation thereof. O daughter of Babylon, who art to be destroyed, happy shall he be that rewards you as you served us. Happy shall he be that takes and dash your little ones against the stones. This is the word of the Lord. In our first reading, we heard how Jesus rode into Jerusalem and how the people came out shouting, "Hosanna, blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord." We are in the Lenten period, as we all know. Today being Palm Sunday, we are preparing ourselves for the Holy Week. 7 days from today, we'll be celebrating the risen Christ, who rose from the dead and overcame death and overcame all the powers of darkness, and is right now seated in heaven at the right hand of the Father. And he is with us, even as he had promised through the Holy Spirit. As we go into this period, we remember where we are as a people of God. We also remember where our country is, and we also remember where the world is. And we are asking ourselves a question, just like the Jews ask themselves questions in Psalm 137 verse 4. The question that they were asking themselves was this: how shall we sing the Lord's song in a strange land? And so today we are asking ourselves the same question: how can we sing? Like the Jews in Babylon under captivity, We are today filled with a lot of anxiety. We feel strange. We feel alienated. We feel displaced. We feel misplaced. We feel unsettled. We are concerned about ourselves. We are concerned about our families. We are concerned about the situation, the whole world around us. It was very difficult for the Jews to sing the songs of Zion away from the temple, which they were used to. Just like today, we are away from our sanctuaries all over the world. It was difficult for them to sing the songs of Zion away from Jerusalem. Jerusalem was the city of the Lord. It was difficult for them to sing the Lord's song in a strange land, a land where there was idolatry, a land that was full of profanities. They hung their harps, as we see in verse number 2. It was no longer time for them to sing. They wept. They cried. As you see in verse 1. And they turned their anger and their wrath to their enemies. The enemies who had taken them away into captivity. Like them. I do feel that this, for us as a church, is not the time for us to sing. The whole world seems to be on its knees. The doors of our churches, they are closed. Over 900,000 people, close to 1 million, right now, as I speak, around the world have been infected by a virus which is causing a disease whose cure is not yet known. Many people are dying in Europe, in America, in Africa, all over the world. We and millions of people have to take refuge in our houses, and we must stay indoors in order to avoid being infected by this deadly virus. Our country, Kenya, right now is under a dusk to dawn curfew. That means that everybody is supposed to be in their houses by 7 p.m. Many countries have already implemented complete lockdown. And we don't know whether other countries are going to follow suit, including our own beloved land. Businesses, industries are closing down. Hundreds of thousands of jobs are disappearing all over the world, day after day. Many people are going without food. And even those ones who have food now, they don't know about tomorrow. The world economy is grinding to a halt. Friends, this is the time for us to weep. This is the time for us to mourn before the Lord. This is the time for us to pray honestly. This is the time for us to refuse not to pray. And we must continue until this great enemy of the universe is defeated. God in heaven is looking for people who are ready to stand between the gap. He's looking for people who are ready to stand and intercede on behalf of his people and intercede on behalf of the whole universe. It's time for the bride and the groom to leave their chambers and come out and pray. From wherever we are, we must continue in prayer, whether we are at home with our families every day at 7 p.m. in the evening or whichever time it is, whether you are at work because we know and we are aware that essential services must continue being offered. And we have our brothers and sisters, parents, colleagues who are out there serving this country, including the nurses and doctors who have put their lives online to take care of those people who are sick. So whether you are at work, whether you are on a journey, you are traveling, and remember that you can only travel if you must, or whether you are in church like we are today, we must continue praying. Our God will hear us. When our God hears us, he is going to restore us. Just like the Egyptians who raised an army and sent a great army to follow and to chase after the Israelites with a plan to destroy the people of God. We also will see coronavirus no more. God destroyed the entire army to ensure that his people were safe. They were able to cross the Jordan safe and secure, heading to the promised land. Because our God will fight for us as we continue being on our knees. And very soon, brothers and sisters, from wherever you are, we will be back again to our churches, to our working places, to our businesses, to our activities, celebrating together and exalting the name of the Lord, because victory is ours. In the name of God the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. It's time for notices. Thank you.
Praise God. My name is Kennedy Stuvi. I'm happy to be here today to bring you the notices. I thank God for this opportunity. Thank you, Vika, for that encouraging word. So the Vika and the PCC welcome all of us to our online Palm Sunday service. Number two, this being a Holy Week, the church encourages families to hold family prayers daily between 8 and 9 p.m. And number three, there will be a Good Friday service, which will be streamed live on 10th April as from 10 a.m. Details will be given in the course of the week. We also intend to go live on the Sunday services. Number four, we are appealing for donations of foodstuff and cash to support our members who have been adversely affected by the current economic crisis. This will be coordinated by the respective cluster coordinators and managed at parish level by the FDC and the mission departments. And number five, we encourage members to reach out to others who are not on our WhatsApp wall so that they can join the WhatsApp account. Number six, we encourage our members to continue supporting the church with their tithes and offerings through our PayBill number or direct deposits to our Bank of Africa account, as communicated earlier. The number is on your screen and it will also be circulated. Thank you very much for listening, and God bless you abundantly.
Let us pray as we come to the end of our service today. Heavenly Father, Almighty God, we thank you for being with us in this service. We commit ourselves to you as we begin the Holy Week. We pray for your presence, even as we meditate upon your word, as we humble ourselves before you and take time in fellowship with you and also with our family members. We pray that, Lord, you're going to guide each and every person on the face of this earth concerning your will in these difficult times. We pray for your blessing and favor upon all those who are at work offering essential services, especially those in the medical profession. We pray also for all those who are in need at this time when many countries have declared lockdown, and also others, like our country Kenya, have declared a curfew. We pray that you open doors so that, Lord, all those who trust and believe in you are going to overcome this challenge. And Lord, we are looking forward even for the day that will come out again to celebrate your goodness, because we know that you are with us. So Lord, bless us and be with us in all things for the glory and honor of your name. In the name of God the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. May the peace of God that passes all understanding guard your souls and mind in the knowledge of our God and of his Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. And the blessings of God Almighty, Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit be with you and dwell with you now and forevermore. Amen.